The first thing I do every morning is I come out and check my little garden here. So everything is growing healthy, nice deep dark green leaves. We got lots of fruit on the tomato plants, just all over the place. Everything growing in the garden stick is looking great. The zucchini is going crazy. And inside here, you can hardly tell, I've got a pepper plant in here trying to find some sunlight, and some over here. So everything's looking great until you look a little bit closer. And I noticed this morning for the very first time some holes on the leaves. And that's the very first sign that you may see. But another sign, and when you see holes in the leaves, look for caterpillar poop. And sure enough, I've got, without having to see the caterpillar itself, I've got tomato worms. And so it is now time to spray a pesticide, an organic pesticide that will take care of that. And this is really good stuff. This is called Thuricide, or it's known in the industry as BT. Go to any nursery, Home Depot, and say, I need some BT, and they know exactly what you're talking about. This is organic. It is actually a bacteria that the worms will eat, and then it will kill them from inside. So what we do here is we just get a little measuring teaspoon. This is actually a half a teaspoon. And we mark here on the container what it is, what the mixture is, that it is a pesticide, and that it's toxic. What we don't have on here are the safety measures, which would be important to have, but they are here on the box, and we keep the instructions together. So I'm going to mix up this BT into here, which is one teaspoon, and then I'm going to come over and spray my plants. Now it's important to make sure not only you spray the top of the leaves, but underneath. You may actually may never see, and hopefully you will never see, a what they call a hornworm or tomato worm, because you got it under control. But if you see these signs, make sure that you take immediate action. Now it's early morning, it is an overcast day, so that's a good time to do it. You don't want to do this in the middle of the day. Of course you don't want to get your leaves wet at any time during the middle of the day, because it burns the leaves. If you can think of a water drop, it's basically a little tiny magnifying glass, and that sun comes in and hits that water drop, and it will burn up leaves. And especially if you've got chemicals that you're putting on your plants, that adds additional problems to leaves. So either do this early morning or in the evening. Your plants will benefit the most from that. So I'm going to go ahead and spray this beautiful tomato plant. Again, this is the one that my wife told me two or three times to throw away. And with the proper watering and the self-watering container gardening system, the proper fertilization, and plenty of sunlight, it's growing like crazy. So, hope this helps you to understand what you need to do. Well, as soon as you see the holes and the poop, get on it immediately. They can destroy a plant very quickly. So don't wait a day or two. Work on it that day if you can do that at all possible. I got halfway done with spraying the BT on the tomato plants, and the sprayer wasn't working to my expectations. Wasn't spraying very well. So I decided, with the two tomato plants I have here and the six other tomato plants that my wife has here, we're going to be doing a lot of spraying. Yes, those are 8 feet tall. At least 8 feet tall. They're up there, and they're loaded with tomatoes. But you can see she's got signs of tomato caterpillars here too. So she's going to be doing a lot of spraying. I don't think she's going to want to be doing that with a little hand pump sprayer. So I'm going to go ahead and put together the sprayer that we have to do more volume spraying. And we got this particular one, not because it's Roundup, but because we felt it was a good quality. It does have a 5-year warranty, which doesn't really mean a lot to me. And it's a 1-gallon container, so it holds a lot more than the little spray bottle. And it's easy to use. You only need 11 pumps to get it under compression. It does have a self-adjusting pressure release. It does have some other nozzles. It has a foaming nozzle, and it has a flat wide sprayed nozzle and adjustable nozzle. We usually just use the adjustable nozzle. It's really easy to put together. I'll have a link down below where you can get this. But even though it says Roundup on it, we're just putting in some BT in this. Now, one thing I want to recommend to you, when you use these kind of spray nozzles, always take the ends apart when you're done and wash them out. Otherwise, you'll get things clogged up and it won't work when you need it the most. So take a little bit of time to do some maintenance, and it'll save a lot of hassle down the road. Now, what we do is we have several sprayers, and we actually just write on the sprayer what it's for. We have one for Epsom salts that she uses on her tomatoes. We have one for BT now. We've got one for seaweed, foliant spray, so far. So we've got three of them right now. Well, that didn't go twice as fast. It went about 20 times as fast and did a lot better job than I would have been able to do with the little spray bottle. Was able to reach in with the nozzle and get in and turn it around and spray up inside of the plants. So I really liked using this heavy-duty sprayer. I really do also like that it's a 1 gallon. You have to remember water is 8 pounds per gallon, and so if you end up getting a 3 or 4 or 5 or 6 gallon container, you better get a backpack one because it gets really heavy. I used about half a gallon here. You can see right here. So it would have been 2 of these bottles that I would have had to make up. So if you have very much spraying to do, you know, these cost a few dollars, but it's well worth the time spent in getting a good coverage for your plants and making it easier and faster for you. You have other things to do and want to go around and enjoy the other plants in your garden.
It's been 5 days since I treated this tomato plant with BT for tomato hornworms. And one nice advantage to having this white plastic down here is you can very easily see if there is any worm poop down here. And as you can see, it is worm poop free. So that one application made a big, big difference, immediately stopped the hornworms. Now, I don't know if we'll have to, as you can see, they do some serious damage here. And we may have to come back and reapply additional BT on here, but that's certainly an easy thing to do with the pump sprayer, and we'll make sure that we control these tomato worms so that they don't come in and destroy this plant that is producing tons of tomatoes here. Just everywhere you look, this great tomatoes here. So I highly recommend the BT. It's completely organic, it's completely safe. You can eat the fruit right after you spray. And so there's no problem in using it, and you'll be able to protect your fruit from getting destroyed by the tomato hornworm, which will completely devour the plant. They make a lot of baby hornworms very quickly, so you want to make sure you keep it under control. This is LDS Prepper reminding you, if ye are prepared, ye shall not fear. And if you use BT, watch your plants, come out and check them every day, and you look for the little poop, you'll be able to control the tomato hornworms and have great healthy plants.